Hello guys, what's up? I hope you all are doing well with the studies of Diploma in Elementary Education. So today we are going to discuss question number 1 of assignment 3 of course 501. That is, visit some schools in your locality and prepare a report on the issue of protecting child rights. So this is the question which we are going to discuss today in this video. You have to write the answer in 100 words. So keep this in mind while writing the assignment. This question consists of 10 marks. So as I have told you all, in there are 3 courses for first semester, course 501, course 502 and course 503, and each course consists of 3 assignments: assignment 1, assignment 2 and assignment 3. Assignment 1 and assignment 2 consist of 4 questions each of 5 marks, and assignment 3 consists of 1 question of 10 marks. So this is your marking scheme. So today we are going to discuss question number 1 of assignment 3. Before starting the video, I would like to channel for the updates of DLED. If you have enrolled in Diploma in Elementary Education, you have to subscribe TasteTube for that. You can get each and everything on this channel because this channel is totally dedicated to you all. You can also watch the solved MCQ test on Swayam or on your channel TasteTube. You have to go on your Swayam app and you have to give some tests also which are going right now, that is on 1st September, unit 1 to 7 for course 503 and unit 9 for course 502. So these tests are going on. You can go to your channel TasteTube and you can search for that. So today we are going to discuss assignment 3, question number 1, that is, visit some schools in your locality and prepare a report on the issue of protecting child rights. After visiting some of the schools in my locality, I found different types of issues on child rights. First of all, we need to understand what are rights and issues related to child rights. A right is as an agreement or contract established between the persons who hold a right, often referred to as the right holders, and the person or institution which have obligations and responsibilities in relation to the realization of that right, often referred to as the duty bearers. Child rights are specialized human rights that apply to all human beings below the age of 18. Universally, child rights are defined by the United Nations and United Nations Conventions of the Rights of the Child, UNCRC. According to the UNCRC, child rights are minimum entitlements and freedoms that should be afforded to all persons below the age of 18, regardless of race, color, gender, language, religion, opinion, origins, wealth, birth, status or ability, and therefore apply to all people everywhere, interdependent and indivisible, meaning that a right cannot be fulfilled at the expense of another right. The purpose of the UNCRC is to outline the basic human rights that should be afforded to children. There are 4 broad classifications of these rights. These 4 categories cover all civil, political, social, economic and cultural rights of every child. Right to survival begins before a child is born. According to Government of India, a child life begins after 20 weeks of conception. Hence, the right to survival is inclusive of the child right to be born, right to minimum standards of food, shelter and clothing, and the right to live with dignity. Right to protection. A child has the right to be protected from neglect, exploitation and abuse at home and elsewhere. Right to participation. A child has the right to participate in any decision making that involves him or her directly or indirectly. There are varying degrees of participation as per the age of maturity of the child. Right to development. Children have the right to all forms of development, educational, mental and physical, emotional development, support system, mental development through education and learning, and physical development through recreation, play and nutrition. Child protection. Considered child protection as the prevention of or responding to the incidents of abuse, exploitation, violence and neglect of children. This includes commercial sexual exploitation, trafficking, traditional practices such as female genital mutilation or cutting, and child marriage. Protection also allows children to have access to their other rights of survival, development, growth and participation. UNICEF maintains that when child protection fails or is absent, children have a higher risk of death, poor physical and mental health, HIV or AIDS problems, displacement, homeless, vagrancy and poor parenting skills later in life. According to the Integrated Child Protection Scheme, ICPS, child protection is about keeping children safe from a risk or perceived risk to their lives or childhood. It is about recognizing that children are vulnerable and hence reducing by protecting them from harm and harmful situation. Child protection is about ensuring that children have a security not to depend on, and if they happen to fall through the holes in the system has the responsibility to provide the child with the necessary care and rehabilitation to bring them back into the safety net. Child protection, prevention, law and policies, processes and sensitization and awareness building. Intervention, laws and policies, access and assistance, immediate relief, SOS attention, restoration of rights or status, cure punish violators, rehabilitation, laws and policies, long-term care until age 18, skill and training, understanding the difference. It is important to understand the difference between these two concepts. Child rights are a set of entitlement and some of them are justifiable in a court of law, but they are not tangible. Protection is one of these rights, but children protection is more than a right. It is a framework or system by which the rights of a child can come to be. The framework consists of various duty bearers: police, school, civil society, who all have roles to play to ensure that a child's rights are met, and in the case that a child's rights are violated, that the violator be brought to justice and care be provided to the child. Child protection is not only treatment but should also be preventive. Risk management needs to take place to reduce the risk of violation of child rights in any circumstances or space. Child protection is hence the means through which all other rights of a child has a right to live a normal childhood in family environment. The child protection framework needs to first take steps to ensure families are able to survive by providing them when health, education and food for free or at minimal cost. The next step is to address the needs of children who have fallen through the cracks, such as destitute, abandoned. The work includes the mechanism to relocate these children into caring families, either through adoption or foster care, and provide these children with the access to health and education services. Hence, the framework is not a single ministry or single government body. It is the interlinking function of all the machineries. So this was our answer to the question, which we have to write in 1000 words. So you have to keep in mind when you are writing the answer, you have to write the answer in 1000 words. You can write the same answer or you can change something if you want to add something extra, or if you want to use your own creativity, you can do it. TageTube, after 2 hours on your channel TageTube. Another update is you can download this PDF from the description. Another update is that you have to subscribe and like this video, and you have to share this video. It will be a balanced compendium of different forms of questions as stated below. There will be 15 multiple choice questions, 15 very short answer type questions, 10 short answer question, 2 long answer question. It is advisable to attempt the multiple choice question on Swayam app. Also note down the questions along with their answers for future reference. Many of these questions might be asked in the exam. So you can download this whole PDF, and all the answers of the assignments of course 501, 502 and 503 will be uploaded on your channel in English and Hindi this week today. And you have to go to your YouTube and you have to type TageTube for further updates. As you can see our logo, you have to open it and you can watch all the videos related to the assignments like question 2, Swayam updates, Swayam solved MCQs, NIOS DL. Let study me and like the video also. You can watch all the videos of assignment of course 501, assignment 1, assignment 2 and assignment 3. All the rest of the assignments will be uploaded soon. Video, watch the two playlists which are above, that is English playlist and Hindi playlist, and click on the circle to subscribe our channel TejTube. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.